Hello and welcome to Prime News with me, Karen DeMello. Let's have a look at the headlines first. The IT professionals in Goa slammed the BJP government's perspective of development. The IT sector complains no benefits received from the IT policy. Calls on the next government to refrain from repeating the same give suggestions. Goa Forward Party demands a state election commission to direct the caretaker government to stop the process of delimitation of wards to village panchayats, says instruction by caretaker government cast shadow on the independence of the SEC. High Court issues notice to NGPDA over Panjim ODP modifications, demands reply within 2 weeks' time, discloses CCP Mayor Surendra Furtado. Electricity Department serves 3 crore rupees demand notice to CCP as outstanding electricity bill of Panjim Market Complex. Now the news in detail. The IT professionals in Goa do not seem to be happy with the BJP government's perspective of development, the IT sector. The IT professionals embarrassed the government for its delay in rolling the incentives, reimbursement and remunerations to the IT startups even after a years of implementation of the IT policy. Thus, they have represented their wish list 2017 to the next government. The IT professionals in the state has demanded the government to disperse the benefits under the IT policy to the startups, give the contracts of upcoming Goa government projects to the startups, involve them in the smart city projects, create a clean and green IT industry and employment avenues.
Androset Media Private Limited Director Prajot Michael, talking to Prime TV, stated that it was high time for the government to give the IT startups in the state the benefits of IT policy that can help the IT professionals and startups to grow. Michael said that the benefits can be in terms of internet, tax benefits, etc. Most of the time, the Goa government projects are awarded to IT companies outside Goa, and the same should be avoided. Goan IT companies should be allowed to bid for the same projects, Michael contended.
The projects that the Goa government undertakes, the IT companies from Goa can get benefits of this. Most of the times I have seen this contracts go to companies which are outside Goa. I think if that can come within Goa, the Goan IT companies can bid for it. I think that will be a great move. That will help the Goan startups to do a major project for Goa government. And as
1+ year for the IT policies that has already come out, I think the government needs to highlight this policy and the remuneration, reinvestment should start flowing to these startups. Panjim is one of the smart cities, and I think a lot of work has been put up already in this state. The same advantage can be also given by the startups in Goa, so that they can work under the umbrella of smart city and can come up with the innovative products. More importantly, this can also facilitate the interest of startups working with the government in terms of Goan projects which a Goa government undertakes. A lot of advantage can be given instead of giving the benefits to the companies outside Goa.
IT professional Vincent Toscano lashed out at government for dreaming big when the IT industry in Goa can be started with limited things. Vincent opined that there is no need for IT parks at an early stage to boost the IT sector. He added that government failed to lend a helping hand to the IT startups in the state despite putting forth various presentations before the IPB and government.
You can start very simple. This is how most of the IT hubs happen. Okay, wherein workspaces were created in existing buildings, okay, be it private, be it government owned. And in Goa, we have so much underutilized government spaces and buildings. If those are refurbished and made workable or livable for the IT professionals to operate out of, okay, you don't need an IT park even to begin with. And something like this could be rolled off within a month.
Around 200 IT startups operate in Goa, and these, with the help of government, could have created over 1,000 net new jobs. The IT department 2 or 3 months back was finding new IT websites to be created by the government, Vincent disclosed. He called on government to stop fooling the IT professionals in the state. He also suggested use of vacant government premises to start IT sector in the state.
Policy and n number of other things. Unfortunately, besides a 4 or 5 pager IT petty IT policy, lacking courage and vision. Okay, more of a transactional operational IT policy besides that, and a number of MOUs and gimmicks done here and there in the name of IT, nothing concrete happened, to the extent that not even a single incentive of the IT policy that was declared more than a year ago has yet been disbursed. Come on now, this is height of it, right? And apparently till 2 or 3 months back, the IT department was figuring out what new website to create for it. Now come on, you can fool rural village goans who may be semi-literate or do not understand the IT world with such kind of gimmicks. But you can't even think or dream of fooling experienced IT folks from the IT world who are abreast of how the rest of the Indian states are moving in this direction, what they are doing, how the world is.
Ex-GCCI President Mangirish Pai Raikar has called on government to provide basic infrastructural facilities to IT startups in Goa. Small IT industries to start with can be a great help for the IT professionals, Raikar stated.
Just IT industry has a great potential of creating jobs for the new generation. Most of the children in Goa are technically savvy, English speaking, and not only that, they have great potential to supplement this industry. So the government of the day should also always focus on this industry and help to establish it, this industry in Goa, first of all by creating proper infrastructure, because that is the most important factor for any industry to establish itself. There was no proper road mapping for developing this industry in the state of Goa. Although they did come out with the IT policy, but its implementation was very, very poor.
For Prime Video Journalist Sunny Narvekar, Panjim.
The Goa Forward Party on Thursday has demanded the State Election Commission to direct the caretaker government to stop the process of delimitation of wards to village panchayat for the upcoming panchayat elections that may be held on May 21st, with immediate effect, and further not to take any cognizance of such delimitation. GFP President Prabhakar Timle, along with General Secretary Mohandas Loilekar, said that the instructions by caretaker government has cast a shadow on the independence of the State Election Commission, which is supposedly a statutory authority for free and fair conduct of elections to local bodies in the state.
The power of delimitation of constituencies should vest the State Election Commission and not the Directorate of Panchayat, as it strikes at the very roots of free and fair conduct of elections. The Goa Forward Party will prevail upon the new government to ensure that the delimitation of wards of panchayat is done under the control and supervision of the State Election Commission. GFP President Prabhakar Timle took strong objection to the hurried up process in which the caretaker government is instructed by the State Election Commission to complete the process of delimitation.
The tariq announced karpachi in consultation with the new government, because jo sadhya kaido pe asa, the State Election Commissioner fixes the date of panchayat elections in consultation with the government. Now you cannot fix a date in consultation with the government which is going to go out of power, or when we are having general elections at all. So this is no consultation at all. So what is the big hurry for the State Election Commission? Why the State Election Commission cannot wait for another 30 days? What's the big hurry there? So jo pay lokansu pay ek pay ashlo ki the State Election Commission itself is a compromised position manun tak tum bhar ditat padte. So at least I say, once you are in that position, be fair. People know that you are a handmaid of the BJP. People know it.
A caretaker government is not expected to take basic and critical decisions. Any delimitation of wards by a government which is rejected by the people at the recent general election would be mockery of justice, and the panchayat elections would be a farce, GFP General Secretary Mohandas Loilekar contended. He also warned that any delimitation done by a caretaker government which has lost the confidence of the people will not be accepted, and the Goa Forward Party will use all its power and might for a delimitation based on intelligible and transparent criteria.
Caretaker government an accept karwa da, caretaker government आणि केअरटेकर गव्हर्नमेंटच्या चीफ मिनिस्टरचं खबर हा की तो इन डेंजर झोन आसा. सो खंयचेही डिसिजन जे इम्पॉर्टंट डिसिजन केअरटेकर गव्हर्नमेंटान घेवप ना अशी एक परंपरा तरी आसन फोर्सान जरी घेतले तरी 11 मार्चा नंतर जे गव्हर्नमेंट येतले तातूंत गोवा फॉरवर्डाचो पाठिंबो आशिल्लेच गव्हर्नमेंट आसतले. आम्ही हे डिलिमिटेशनाचे परते कमिशनराक आणि डायरेक्टर ऑफ पंचायताक सांगतले की रिव्ह्यू करपाक कित्याक आमकां 100% खबर हा की आतां जर डिलिमिटेशन जर केले तर ते बीजेपी आपल्या जाय तशें करतले जशें फातोर्डाचे 53 घर पयर काण घातिल्ले त्या टायमार बशें. सो आमकां हे आसा केअरटेकर गव्हर्नमेंटाक इल्लो सुद्दां रायट ना ताणें फक्त काम चलावो करपाचो जे सेक्रेटरी फायल धाडटा थंय फक्त सही मारपाचें काम करपाचें.
For Prime Video, journalist Aditya Bidre, Margao.
Corporation of City of Panjim, Mayor Surendra Fittado disclosed that the High Court has issued notice to North Goa Planning and Development Authority over Panjim Outline Development Plan modifications, asking NGPDA to reply within 2 weeks' time. The order came after the mayor had filed writ petition regarding the modification, stating that CCP was not taken into confidence during rectifications in ODP. Fittado, addressing a press conference, disclosed that the electricity department has served 3 crore rupees demand notice to CCP as outstanding electricity bill of Panjim Market Complex.
CCP Mayor Surendra Fittado alleged BJP-led government of harassing the CCP. Fittado also alleged that Panjim MLA Siddharth Kunkolekar prioritized the outline development plan rather than development of Panjim. Fittado was confident of change in the governance and that of Athanasio Monserrat coming to power.
To the outgoing government, that they harassed our panel for 3 years. 2 years whenever the mayor, and this is the third year, all our development were blocked. They took CCP for granted. They will not take us into confidence. When the present MLA went to the people of Panji during the bi-polls, he had never said that his priority will be ODP to have 8 stories and 9 stories building in Panji city. City department, Panji, to pay 3 crores as a power bill of the market.
What is the time you are?
I don't know, my ATO came and showed me that thing.
What is the cutoff
time? They must have given, no other they'll do it.
For Prime Video, journalist Mahesh Wangankar, Panjim.
The prime highlight of Goa, the Carnival Festival, will start from 25th February. This year, the CCP has changed the route of the Carnival Parade from Miramar to Karanzalem, stating that it will not lead to traffic congestion. However, President of Panjim Traditional Festival Committee, Joachim Tellis, does not seem to be happy with the development. Joachim has termed the change of the route as killing of the festival. He stated that the change of route should be the decision of the government and not of the Corporation of City of Panjim. Joachim called on the CCP to also change the route for Shigmo Festival and not Carnival alone.
One cannot take the decision of changing the Carnival parade route while code of conduct is on. Is CCP the government? President of Panjim Traditional Festivals Committee Joachim Tellis questioned. He said that the existing route is attractive and the Miramar to Karanzalem route will not see the same participation of the people. Joachim added that the locals were not taken into confidence regarding the same.
Announced by the tourism department yesterday and today. In fact, today's Times of India says that the route has been changed from Miramar to Donapal instead of below the bridge till Kalagadami. Now, first of all, I ascertain from tourism department, there are no government approval for changing of the route because this is a major decision. Since this is a major decision, you cannot take a decision when code of conduct is there. Now, the tourism people say that CCP has approved. Now, CCP has approved means what? CCP is the government because this decision of this existing route was taken when Ravi Naik was the chief minister. There is a government approval. Now, tourism people, they say, tourism department people say that CCP has approved. Now, CCP or the Minister for Tourism can overrule decision of the government? Definitely not. And this is a major decision. So they have to take the views of the public, because public interest is concerned here. That has not been taken. Public views not taken.
The traditional parade route is changed after receiving complaints from the regarding traffic congestion. This year, the float parade will pass from Miramar to Karanzalem, President of Carnival Committee Deepak Desai disclosed. However, the programs on 26, 27 and 28 will continue as usual in the city, Desai added. The floats too will have to go through strict vigil. The floats will only be approved after the screening committee approves the same. Any unfit vehicles won't be allowed that poses the risk of accidents, Desai informed. 23rd Feb is the last day to submit the entry for floats.
We had a meeting yesterday for the organizing committee in the Panji. This time organizing committee is all of the officers. That is a department, no politician and others are included in this. Now yesterday only we had a meeting, so this route is finalized. The date is finalized, 4 o'clock float will start from Miramar to the Karandale. And the other 4 days from 25th, 26th, 27th, 28th, other program will be in the city. That is as usual. There are a lot of program, evening some programs are there. That meeting we have not given, so from yesterday we have started giving that. So 23rd is the last date to give the entry for the floats. There is a screening committee. Also, there is one more committee of the officer like the DYSP, traffic, then RTO, fire brigade, myself, who will finalize the floats for the entry. Because there are many complaints that Nagadalyo Gadiyo Geneta, the vehicle which are not fit to run in the on the road, which causes inconvenience, may accident also happen. So as per the Motor Vehicle Act, this vehicle cannot run on the road. Since the float, although it is a festival, we have to take care that there should not be any accident.
CCP Mayor Surendra Furtado said that while shifting the traditional carnival parade from Panjim to Miramar, office of the mayor was not acknowledged.
Returnable in 2 weeks' time. We are confident that we have full faith in judiciary. We are confident that the High Court will give a befitting reply to NGPDA and to the government for bypassing the corporate city of Panjim.
For Prime Video journalist Mahesh Wangankar and Sunny Narvekar, Panjim.
With the Supreme Court ordering ban on all liquor shops within 500 meters of national and state highways across the country on 15 December 2016, the Excise Department in the state has disclosed that only after it gets physical identification of the prohibited structures and getting the same marked on the survey plan, show cause notices can be sent to the liquor shops and stop renewing the licenses from March 31st, the date set by Honorable Supreme Court. Excise Commissioner Minino D'Souza also disclosed that the department aims to issue show cause notices to around 2,500 to 3,000 liquor shops.
There is a need to map the highway on the plan and get the survey numbers. The exercise is quite huge and it does not only relate to the excise department but also involves the work of other departments like Land Survey Authority, PWD, National Highways Authority, Panchayats, etc. Excise Commissioner Minino D'Souza informed. He also said that the department failed to take swift action due to the elections. In a meeting held on Thursday evening, the department has ordered for constituting taluka-wise team that will be led by Mamladar to identify the prohibited liquor shops. The team includes PWD officials, excise inspector and other department officials. Training to the team will also be provided by 21st February.
They have to also be made which are actually readable by the ground staff. After this, we have to constitute taluka level committees, which includes my excise inspectors, the land survey inspectors, the taluka mamladars, Talatis, village panchayat secretaries, they will go on site with these plans and they will identify each of the structures which come within this 500 meters. And after that, we'll have to take action of issuing the show cause and non-renewing the licenses from 1st April 2017. So what we have done is now is government.
It can be recalled that the Supreme Court had banned all liquor shops within 500 meters of national and state highway across the country with an aim to reduce drink and drive and road accidents that claim thousands of lives every year.
Of December 2016, Supreme Court had issued an order that all liquor licenses within 500 meters from the outer edge of the highways, both national highways, state highways and service lanes to the highways, their licenses will not be renewed after 31st March 2017. So that means our job is to first identify which are the licenses within this prohibited area, for which actually first we have to map the highways on the plans, get the survey numbers of the license premises and identify this which come within this 500 meter line. So this exercise is quite huge, and then it is not only that exercise department has to do.
For Prime Video journalist Sunny Narvekar, Panjim.
Now it's time for a short break. Stay tuned.
Jose Cabral Enterprises, NX brings to you the widest range of bicycle and fitness equipments in Goa. With more than 65 years of experience in bicycle and fitness industry, we deliver the best to our delighted customers. Why Jose Cabral? Because we have it all for all ages. Indian and imported top leading multi-geared bicycle and fitness equipment brand Giant, Hero, Schnell, Fuji, Cannondale, Hercules, Atlas. Do visit us at Jose Cabral Enterprises NX at Kurtarkar Shopping Center near Hari Mandir, Margao, Goa. Contact 9970952536. Choice Modern Furnishing. Make your home as unique as you. We have wide range of ready-made curtains, curtain materials, upholstery material, bed sheets, blankets, mattresses, carpet, wall-to-wall carpets, center carpet, Nelton, blinds, music pillows, and many more. First time in Goa, furniture is made of aluminium that requires no maintenance, no termite problem, no dampness. Furniture is light in weight, easy to install. Choice Modern Furnishings. Our address, shop number 5, Sujoy Apartments, next to Hotel Sunrise, opposite Sushila Building, 18 June Road, Panjim. Contact 0832-2231-813. Agile Modular Kitchen, one-stop solution for all your kitchen and interior needs. We welcome you to the world of dream kitchen and interiors. We provide our customers with a combination of quality design and service at an affordable price. Also specialized in modern beds, TV unit, wardrobe, paintings, etc. We also avail 3 years warranty and 1 year maintenance totally free. For reliability, interiors and excellence, Agile is the place to visit. Near Duler Football Stadium, Mapsa, Goa. Contact Snehal Shirodkar and Swaham Kalangutkar. At Agile, we build your dream.
Welcome back. Goa Government Employees Association President John Nazareth on Thursday submitted his resignation as a president and working committee member to the General Secretary of GGEA. Nazareth stated that he submitted his resignation after there were allegations made against him of he being responsible for the pending accounts of the committee and for going on Ranchi and Kolkata tour without taking prior permission from GGEA. Nazareth said that a Goan Marathi daily too had published wrongly about him. Nazareth added that it is deliberate attempt of one of the committee members to defame him.
John Nazareth disclosed that he had nothing to do with the pending accounts and the accounts were maintained by the General Secretary. He also disclosed that the Treasurer Khushali Halankar was caught up in election duty and the allegations against him are also false. Nazareth said that the act of defaming him came after he presented a proposal to the committee to amend the constitutional aspect of the committee.
हमें एक प्रपोजल मांडलो कि आमची घटना पे हा संघटनेची जे कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन आ तितून अमेंडमेंट करूंक जाय म्हण कित्याक अमेंडमेंट हांवें सांगलेले की आमी कोणाकोणाकूय पीक एंड चूज करून कमिटीन हाडटा एक एक तालुकाचे जायते लोक आसता दुसरे तालुकाक रिप्रेजेंटेशनूच ना हांवें म्हटलेले फ्रॉम एवरी डिपार्टमेंट वी वील हॅव वन पर्सन वन ओर टू पर्सन्स आनी हे लोकांनी इलेक्ट करून आपले तालुकाचो मनीस इलेक्ट करपाचो आनी हो तालुकाचो मनीस सेंट्रल कमिटीचेर वयतलो आनी जरी तर तो पत्तो रिकॉन्टेस्ट जातलो जाल्यार आफ्टर ए पिरियड ऑफ 3 इयर्स ताचे पर्फोमन्स पळोवनूच ताका रिइलेक्ट करतले ना जाल्यार ताका रिइलेक्ट करचे ना आनी अशें करून आमी संघटनेची क्वॉलिटी जे बरे मनीस येवपाक हांवें प्रयत्न पळय केलोलो हो म्हाका दिसता कोणाक तरी वायट पडलो आनी म्हाका दिसता एलिगेशन केलें की हांवें कमिटी कन्सल्ट करूंक ना मागीर म्हणटा हांव दुसऱ्या बाराबर हांवें प्रेस कॉन्फरन्स घेतलें प्रेस कॉन्फरन्स नॉन गव्हर्मेंट सर्वंटाक घेवन हांवें एकूय घेवंक ना बाब काशिनाथ सिटी एक फाटी थोडे इशू आसले की थोडे गव्हर्मेंट सर्वंट एका इलेक्शन कँडिडेटांक कॅम्पेनींग करता म्हणून आनी तेन्ना तो एक गव्हर्मेंट सर्वंटूच ताका लागून ताकाय जाय आसलें वायट जावचें न्हू गव्हर्मेंट सर्वंटाक ताका लागून आमी एक जॉयंट प्रेस ब्रिफींग घेतलेलें.
फॉर प्राईम व्हिडिओ जर्नलिस्ट सनी नार्वेकर, पांजिम.
Martin, a film by Prasad Creation, has been nominated in jury section of Noida International Film Festival just within 15 days of releasing the movie. Jitendra Shikerkar, director of Martin, expressed his happiness over film's nominations. He stated that Konkani cinema has started to receive wide appreciations. Shikerkar hoped that Martin 2 excels like Enemy movie of Prasad Creations that won the national award.
आमचो सिनेमा मार्टीन हो नोयडा इंटरनॅशनल फिल्म फेस्टिवलाक सिलेक्ट जाल्लो आसा आनी ताचे खातीर आमकां खूब खोस भोगता कारण पिक्चर रिलीज जावन 15 दिसां भितर आमचो सिनेमा आमी फेस्टिवलाक धाडिल्लो आनी त्या फेस्टिवलांत उत्स्फूर्त प्रतिसाद मेळ्ळो. पयलोच फावटी धाडिल्ल्या फेस्टिवलाक आमी स्पेशल कॅटेगरी भितर म्हणजे ज्युरी सेक्शना भितर सिलेक्ट जाल्ले आसात आनी कोंकणी सिनेमाक आतां बरे दीस आयिल्ले आसात. वेगवेगळे सिनेमा वेगवेगळ्या पांवड्याचेर पावत आसात. आमचो मार्टीनूय आज एक पयलें पावल घालता फेस्टिवला भितर आनी तो सिलेक्ट जाल्ले बद्दल आमकां खूब खोशी भोगता.
फॉर प्राईम व्हिडिओ जर्नलिस्ट स्वप्नील तारी, पांजिम.
A proud moment for Goan as the President of India has approved award of 398 gallantry and other defence decorations to armed forces personnel and others on the eve of 68th Republic celebrations. The prominent among the list of defence decorations to armed forces personnel is the son of Soil, Captain Sanjay Savio de Cunha, who is presently the commanding officer of INS Mandavi Vere. Captain De Cunha will be conferred with Vishisht Seva Medal. Tell us how you like this newscast. WhatsApp is on 9637969244 or email us on newsprimegoa@gmail.com. Well, that's all for the news now. Stay tuned for more news and updates. Till then, keep watching Prime.